This is a video on how I can approximate such a point cloud by a B-spline curve. I use in this case an algorithm from the SkiPy library. It's the forward-backward filter and SkiPy's signal library. Here in the website there is an example how it works. And I have loaded the point cloud. We see we can see here an ID of the curve, but also we have here some artifacts we have to eliminate. And the first thing what we do is we define a sketch which is near the point cloud, and in the next step I calculate from any point of the point cloud to this curve a distance line, something like this. And then I use the filled method of SkiPy to calculate a wire. And what we see is here this artifact still has a small influence on the curve, but it's really very small. Here at the end we can get better results if we use a better sketcher B-spline. In this case some correlation is not exact. Some of these points are connected to this side of the B-spline, but they have to be connected to the other one. This can be improved, but in most cases the approximation is good. And in the next step I use from here the Daubin algorithm to create the approximation curve. We have it here. So we can see this curve, and what we can do, we can create for this curve the curvatura comp, and when we look at this we see we only have here a strong curvatura in most part of the curve. The approximation is very good, and we only have small changes in the curvature. And I can change some parameters to see the effects. So here is the point cloud of the Taubin algorithm. Here we have two parameters, and so we see how the curve can be changed. Okay, the other effect I want to demonstrate is the influence of the filter, of the SkiPy library filter. Here we see the calculated wire, and when I change the degree and the threshold for the filter, I can see how the curve here changes. For example, if I go down degree to 1, I see here we have more artifacts, and if we upper the low filter we also see this effect. So if I say 140, we see how strong the influence is. And if I go back to a small value, I get a smooth curve. And so on. I can go down to 1. Oh, 1000. And 1. And then the curve is very smooth. And here I change the degree. And I also can change the count number for the smooth. In this case, 10. I get this approximation, and if I put it to 30 poles, I get this approximation.